All right, so here we go. The Logitech G915 TKL. It is finally here. Another piece to the SFF build. And, you know, when you want to use your keyboard on the couch and on your bed, and, you know, you could just take it with you. Anyway. So, clearing this mouse pad here, but I think it's just making it more dirty. I don't know, it's these cotton nail wet wipes, and they're not doing a good job. Anyway, so we got the keyboard, and we do not have a... Oh, we do. Alright, we got a knife. So, if you want to get this keyboard, and you're a college student, you can buy this for... I think maybe 25% off, if I'm not wrong. So basically, the full-size keyboard is $250, and the TKL is $229. And if you use Dr. Lupo's discount code, I think you can get it for $212, and if you use the Honey coupons, it comes out to $196. I think something like that. But if you get it with your college EDU, then you can get it for, I believe, $172.49, I think. So, you know, if you're a college student or you got a friend who's got an EDU, I mean, it's definitely worth your while. So, let's see, can I fix this angle more? Maybe that looks a bit better. Hopefully. Alright, so here's the keyboard. And the box got a good amount of heft to it. I'm not sure if I'll include the photo of how FedEx dropped it off, because the thing was smashed. The box was super damaged, so honestly, you would have thought this keyboard was broken. But yeah, it's actually got a good amount of weight to it. Anyway, we'll put this here. So inside, you can see, you know, it comes with a little... Maybe I can zoom? Ah, that is a good amount of zoom. Yeah, you can see it comes with the little adapter, just like the G Pro Wireless. And it comes with the dongle. I really hope that I could just use one dongle for the G Pro Wireless and the keyboard. I'm not sure if that's possible, but I really hope it is, because that would just make it easier. I do have to take this out. And we have the little micro USB adapter. A lot of people are really upset this doesn't have USB-C. I don't blame you. The keyboard's $229. It's ridiculous. You're probably going to ask me, hey man, do you like your Dygma Raise more than this? Yeah, obviously I like my Dygma Raise more than this. I literally only got this to use it on my other desk with my OLED television. And then, you know, if you want to chill on a couch, or it's just a lot easier for me to pack and bring on the go. I don't really want to bring my Raise with me everywhere. But yeah, I mean, you could bring this, and it's wireless with no latency. I've looked at a lot of wireless keyboards. I checked out the Keymove 61. I think I got my sister the Keymove 67, or whichever was the one with the arrow keys and the double space bar. But yeah, just basically tells you how to set it up. It's nothing special. I just wanted to know if there's anything else in the box. No, that's pretty much it. Okay, so we're going to take this plastic wrap off. And it's a lot of noise. Alright, there we go. I got the tactile switches, so these would be equivalent to Browns. The way I tested them is because Dygma includes all of the little low profile switches, so you can try them out. I was thinking about linears because I was basically going to use this for games all the time. But after using cherry browns, which are basically just linears with the most tiniest bump, if you can call it a bump, a real tactile switch and a direct upgrade is definitely the coil speed coppers. Those feel smoother and just better than browns in every way. Unless you really want linears with the slightest bump. The slightest bump, so you can feel... But honestly, it's not premium tactile. Yeah, so if you ever click on pens and stuff, this is where the pen click noise comes from. I don't have no idea where the video stopped recording, but yeah, here is where the click bar is. Let's see, can I get up closer? Yep, right there. Anyway, this isn't a video to make you go crazy with clicky switches. And I know some of you guys like them, you know, cherry blues. But if you had to hear that, you know, on an open Blue Yeti mic and you're playing with your friend, you'd go crazy. This is what the brown switches like in this sound like. Close up. It's nice. So, in general, it's just got enough of a feedback so it... I like that noise. Anyway. So... there's some dust on my button. These buttons, I know this is the major complaints everybody said. The volume buttons. They don't feel as good as the rest of the keyboard. I don't know how they would make a tiny mechanical switch for all of these little rubber buttons, but it does feel off. It feels like you're... I don't know if you've ever been to, like, Disneyland or an arcade or... I gotta think of a better example. Look, when you go to, like, some place where they got really mushy buttons, these feel really mushy buttons. Where have I felt these before? Maybe an arcade somewhere. Nobody goes to arcade anymore. We don't live in Japan. Japan has arcade exclusives, so if you want, like, you know, the new Gundam game, they actually have an exclusive for the arcade, but you won't get it for the console for a while. Here's the volume bar. There's no feedback on it, just, you know, blade, let it rip. Here, I'll actually turn it on. I don't think there's any more plastic on it. This is the bottom, and you can see where the first adjustment, second adjustment, and then they both close at the same time. That's nice. We'll see how this feels. Let's zoom out. All right. It's not bad. I definitely don't like the Ducky or those 65% keyboards in general. Like, even like the keyboard that I mentioned before, its angle just slopes too high. Like on the mass drop all high profile, it's just this angle is just too high. Unless you use like a wrist rest, I feel like it aggravates my wrist. Like, I guess it helps if you want to reach across the board. We're not gonna do this debate now, because I know people who really like ortholinear keyboards are gonna say, "Oh man, well, all of them are bad." But using this right now without a wrist rest, like I would pretty much everywhere I go, I would either bring this wrist rest, I mean, my bad, this mouse pad with me, or I have another Corsair MM300, I believe. Those are like $15 on sale. Those are perfectly fine to carry around with you. But yeah, this is basically it. You know, this is the keyboard I've wanted, and we'll actually turn it on. I mean, I don't really need it on to tell, but you can see the lights. So it's blinking, battery. I have no idea how to change color modes. I just know this is brightness. Bluetooth. Don't know what that one does. Volume. Lightspeed. Bluetooth. Wireless. I'm going to connect this to the computer and we'll see how fast it responds, if it actually responds as, you know, as fast as the G Pro Wireless. Alright, so here we are. This is the little tiny monitor that I have, and the G915 TKL little adapter. So I'll pop this into my USB hub. And setting it up. I don't think you can see the top monitor, so I'll just set up everything to run off the bottom one. If you're wondering why the configuration is all weird, I was just playing with just different monitors. I was looking at which one if I want to replace this and what they get. There's 4K 144Hz monitors coming out later this year, 1440p 240Hz. We got a lot of options. I was looking at the newer, faster ultra wides. I'm not entirely convinced just because they're not that great, you know. You still have no real HDR. It's $1,800 for a G-Sync 38-inch 1600p ultra wide, and it's HDR 600. You're paying $1,799 and it has a fan in it. I don't want a monitor with a fan in it. I already showed you guys I put the PC in the closet. I don't want a monitor with a fan. That's, you're just asking for that to break. And then these policies, like LG's RMA on the monitors, I mean, you only have a 1 year warranty. At least when you buy an Acer or when you buy a Asus, like this is an Asus monitors, I believe AOC, who else is there? Dell. They're all 3 year warranties. Dell has a 3 year advanced exchange warranty, so that's nice. I know AOC includes a 3 year warranty and then 1 year accidental protection for free. You know, when you buy certain of their gaming line monitors, I don't want to say every single one, I just the ones that are, you know, for the gamers and stuff. Anyway, I'll set up the bottom monitor as the default so everything loads up on here. Alright, so yeah, the bottom one's the default. There's the mouse. And let's see. What to launch? I guess I'll just launch. I could launch Call of Duty, right? I could launch Doom. Yeah, I'll launch Doom. Let's load up a little typing test. Alright, now it's launching Doom. Where is this audio? Audio is coming from the TV, so I'll set it to the monitor speakers. One second. Alright, we're back. So, I had Doom on the TV, so it's not going to load on my monitor, obviously. And we'll put on... I just have it set to FPS mode, so it's not going to look nice. Put on racing mode, maybe user one look nice as well. I think racing mode will look good to most of you guys. The RGB mode, like when you use sRGB, it's nice, you know, you get accurate colors, but I don't know if you guys would like it. In general, oversaturation, popular, you know, higher contrast ratios. But yeah, let's load this up. Obviously, I can pretty much max out everything, you know, it's 1080p. And I'll just hit continue from where I left off. It was set to HDR on my television, so that's why I had to pause the video, come back. But yeah, look, everything runs pretty smooth. Got hit. Where'd it go?
The betrayer's life signal is nearby.
Everything seems like it's run smooth. If the audio is too loud, I'm not sure, so I'll just lower it a bit. But the speakers are pretty nice. Like, if you were gonna just bring this somewhere, like this would be a setup, you know, wireless keyboard. One con real quick. Right now I am using this with a micro HDMI. I did see online that the new RTX cards that are gonna be coming out, the 30 series, do not have a USB-C. So the whole USB-C one cable to charge the monitor and to also use it for display won't be possible. Video cut off. But basically, I plugged in the little USB-C. This is going from my other monitor. My bad. It's going from the USB hub to the monitor. And it's only probably like 1 amp of power. It's not a lot. And it's enough to charge, power the monitor at the same time, even if like your battery is dead. And I'm using this with a micro HDMI. If you're keeping up with the leaks, the new RTX 30 series don't use USB-C like the what's it called? The 20 series. The 20 series has the USB-C virtual link port. So that's a con, but would I say go out and buy a 2080 Ti and not a 30 series just because you want one cable? No, absolutely not. If you guys keep up with the leaks, the new cards look like they're going to be really good. Even the new AMD cards look like they're going to be really good. So I'm excited. But yeah, this is running like 300 FPS, all on ultra, 1080p. It runs nice, it runs really smooth. The only con that I would say with this little tiny monitor is when you try to play games like Call of Duty Warzone, or you try to see really far away, like far, you really won't be able to see that far. It's hard to scan like wide areas with it. But when you try to use it for, let's say, things like, you know, just really fast-paced gun game and stuff like that, it's not that bad at all. It's really nice. Oh, wow. Wasn't sure I was going to make that. But, yeah, as you can see, like, it feels pretty fast. I know I'm just running around, jumping around, not doing anything special. But when I did use Bluetooth 5.1 on the key move, because that was basically the best wireless keyboard I could find, it honestly is almost like Logitech wireless. Obviously it's not. So I am really happy to finally get like real wireless support that actually doesn't have lag. And it's really nice. I mean you know who you are if you want this. They're coming for me. Oh. Oof. Really messing up here. So that was a good amount of Doom. We're just alt tab. I can load up Notepad so you can see what the latency. Actually, I can load up an actual, you know, something for you to notice me typing. Yeah, we'll load up like a little typing test. Typing test. What is the best one? No idea. We'll just check out the first one available. 1 minute test, text. Yeah, we'll do 1 minute text. All right, we're good. That was not a good score, but there you go. Probably the gloves. You know, it's probably the gloves. But hey, it works. I mean, let's see. What's something that, there's nothing really I can test to respond, but like, when I'm typing, it feels just like wired. I don't feel any difference. It's just really nice. Like, this is finally out. This is finally possible. The only thing that would be really nice is if we could get a 60% version of this, or maybe a 65% version. So this would be eliminated, this whole bar, and then here. And then it'd be a little tiny little portable keyboard. Maybe. Let's see. They could put the arrow keys along the side, make it a little bit bigger. And you know what? To make it easier, I think they should make a custom layout. So maybe 60% might be a little bit too complicated, and 65% might be a little too complicated with all these little buttons. Or they could keep the buttons and make it bigger. But what would be better would be have the keys just like this. So they can have all the F layer keys, if you've ever seen those like 70% boards. And are they called 75? Something like that. So basically, you'll leave this hole here and be connected. Arrow keys on the side as well. Maybe you can fit like a home or an end or a page up, page down around here. And then have these keys just be another layer. So you maybe have to hold FN and then just trigger Lightspeed and then Bluetooth. And you know, these little buttons could replace these, just a layer. These buttons here, layer. And then still keep the volume. Little scroll wheel. That's really nice. You see in the background? You can see it. See, it's responsive. It's nice. It's a really nice board. I mean, I did a typing test. I showed you playing Doom. I have no idea what else I would show, but yeah. I wish it wasn't as expensive as it is, but until something else comes out that's like this, I doubt you're going to get any other options. But Logitech G Pro wireless with this keyboard, that's it. I mean, that's pretty much it. You got a little wireless thing. And you know what is nice? This metal, if you can see this little metal look, actually matches the metal look on this monitor perfectly. And if you actually look at the back of this monitor, it, same thing, has a very similar look. So it's nice. It matches, you know. Another thing, I don't think you're going to be able to find replacement keycaps for this, so if you still wanted to, you know, go full custom, you'd probably have to get a custom keyboard, build one. But yeah, the final conclusions, it's great. There's nothing like it on the market. I'm happy. I really wanted one of these. We're probably, maybe you'd make one like this, but have a hot swap keys in it. I really wish there was a way that we could get the Logitech wireless in the Raise, you know, that would be really nice. Maybe Dygma can, I don't know. I mean, I doubt there'll ever be like a partnership, or maybe Logitech can make a little like wireless adapter, you know, and they could sell it, but that would defeat the purpose. That's proprietary, and they'd probably never do that. Anyway, yeah. Because if you could, then you could just attach it to, you know, your mass drop all. It has two USB ports, right? So on one side you can put the wire, and the other side you can put the wireless, or then just have it like that. It doesn't have a battery. Maybe you could build one. If there was a way that I could get the wireless, maybe module or whatever the chip, it's probably attached to the PCB, so there's no way of doing it. I'd probably have to look into it, but if there was a way to get Logitech wireless on other keyboards, especially like custom, you know, 65% or whatever switches you wanted, that'd be really nice, you know, because that would be pretty much everything everybody wants. We're probably never going to get that. Probably not for like a decade. And that's if. Maybe the closest thing would be Logitech makes a 10-key TKL version of this, and they let you hot swap the switches. And then you can put in whatever you want. It would still be, you know, together. It would never be a split board. I don't think they'll ever make anything like the Raise unless they partnered up with Raise and then put their wireless in there and they had a battery version. That would be cool. Probably be $100 more. And I'm sure there would be some people that would buy it. I don't think I could convince most of my friends, maybe one person, to get it, but yeah, I guess you just have to have RSI, or like you need to like mess up your hands to actually want a split board. I actually have a friend who refuses to get a split board because he doesn't like having three wires on his desk. He only wants one. And from an aesthetic standpoint, that does make sense. But yeah, that's pretty much it. The board's really nice. It doesn't really have any latency. And thank you for watching. ! Bye-bye. Just real quick, this is what the switches look like up close. And just gonna spam. Even though they're low profile, they still feel like regular switches. The travel even feels just like regular switches. You get used to the low profile pretty fast. And that's all, folks. All right, so here we go. This is the Logitech G Pro Wireless set to audio visualizer mode. And then we have the G915 TKL also set to audio visualizer mode. So now I'm going to go to Brave. And now I'm going to open up a new tab, go to YouTube. Now we're going to ignore all of this clickbait. What are we going to search? What is non-copyright music? We'll just look up space demo, HDR space demo. Pretty sure there shouldn't be non-copyright music in these. Okay, go ahead. The only demo I clicked on with no audio. There you go. Do I actually have to set it to max? I'm gonna be honest, this is very lackluster. Hold up. There's probably gotta be a way to sync up the audio visualizer with the screen, right? Screen sampler? Is that the only way I can do it? Left, rattle, right? You can't do the whole screen. I'm trying to do the same thing that you can do on the Philips Hue Sync. Fixed, reactive. Yeah, I'd want audio visualizer on reactive. That's, okay, we'll do screen sampler and then also set this one to. Oh wow, for the mouse you can't set it to middle. You can only set it to the corners. And then just color boost is an option. All right, I'll do bottom right because that's where my mouse is. All right. I'll turn off the lights. See if this helps. To be honest with you, it was kind of lackluster, so let me just put on something I actually know is kind of happy and colorful. I just put on the Persona 5 opening. Persona 5 opening, that's what it is. What's the dancing one? Persona 5, the dancing theme, what is that? Dancing Stars theme. It's not even HD, but it'll work. So that's okay. It's not that amazing, but it is.